Greetings and salutations, people, and welcome back to Vinyl Reviews with John. Today, we're talking about the Shag's philosophy of the world. This is widely considered to be the worst album ever created. I have no clue where to really start with this. I guess something interesting about this is actually the very first vinyl I'm reviewing in this series by a band that has females in it. I've done 7 reviews, and all of them have been by bands that are composed of guys. That's a lot of penises. But I think the best place to start with this album is its extremely infamous background. At some point in time, a man named Austin Wiggins Jr. got a palm reading fortune telling from his mother. Eventually, his mom was gonna die, and after that, he'd have some daughters, and those daughters would grow up to be in a famous rock band. And he titled the band The Shags. That's not a very good name, is it? Not to mention, this record came out in 1969, so he booked some studio time, and basically the engineer was like, okay, these girls are not at the level of proficiency to use a studio and make a studio record. And Austin Wiggins Jr. was just like, nope, I gotta strike while the iron is hot, you silly goose. So let's spin the record and experience firsthand this 69 shagging. God, he really didn't think that name through. The album kicks off with the title track, Philosophy of the World, which is basically how the planet is never pleased with anything. Everyone, once they achieve a goal, they just want more. Now, I do believe that these girls were really trying as hard as humanly possible to make a good, listenable record, but they were still amateurs who didn't really know how to play their instruments perfectly, or tune their guitars, or play in time with each other. But if you're willing to look past these flaws, you can actually find some really good stuff in this album, which is what I did, which is why I really love this album. And the lyric writing is very good on the album, but a lot of the times it can also be extremely childish, as evident with the second track, That Little Sports Car. That Little Sports Car is a very stupid song that's about, like, one of the girls spotting a sports car, and she's like, oh, yeah, I gotta follow that sports car, because it's going somewhere, and I want to be there too. But when she got to where the sports car was, it wasn't there. Oh, no! Up next is the song, Who Are Parents? Now, this song, it's really sweet, but it's kind of concerning when you think about it, because this song isn't a song about how their father isn't good. It's actually about how parents are awesome. Yay! The overall sentiment of the song is very sweet, and it's very adorable. Quote Cactus Malpractice, this song sounds like Stockholm Syndrome. The fourth song, oh boy. So this is widely considered to be the worst song on the album. This song is called My Pal Foot Foot. Oh boy, this song is a shit show. So let's hear this song, drum roll please. Yeah, this song sort of starts out with sort of a drum solo, and then it devolves into complete and utter chaos. You have Helen Wiggin just slamming away at the drums, trying to play as fast as possible, but being very inconsistent with her timing, whilst Betty and Dot are just slowly strumming these very gross-sounding chords because their guitars aren't in tune. That was a real experience, to say the least, but let's hope the next song is better. Oh my god, it's not. This song is extremely violent sounding. And up next is the last track off of side A, I'm So Happy When You're Near. This song is a very adorable song, basically saying, I'm so happy when we get to be together, and I'm not happy when we can't. Overall, this song's nice. Time to flip the record, and when spinning side B, you, this track is called Things I Wonder, which starts out being like, I wonder why does the world work the way it does? Like, but then it gets pretty sad when she starts singing about why does, like, this boy I'm dating, why is he so bad? And it's actually pretty sad. The next track is the best on the album. It's really sad, and it's called Sweet Thing. This song is all about how one of the girl's boyfriends, he used to be such a great guy, and now he's just a complete jerkwad. And like, really listening to these songs makes me really feel bad for the Shags, because these were girls who did not have a very fortunate luck streak when it comes to life. I don't know if like, one of the girls was actually dating an awful guy or not, but you know, if that's actually true, that's actually really sad. And this song really makes you want to stop poking fun at them because, you know, this is just a really sad album when you think about it. So Halloween is coming up in about a month, and it seems perfect to talk about this album, because the next song is called It's Halloween. It's Halloween, it's Halloween, it's time for spins, it's time for spins, it's Halloween, it's Halloween. This is one of the few happy songs on the album. It's basically just saying how the girls, they love the Halloween. They Why even Dracula will be there? I really like that. This song's just, it's too cute. It's Halloween. Alright, we are nearing the end of this album. It's basically in pissing distance. This is the third to last track called Why Do I Feel? Now, musically, this is actually probably the best on the album, because, well, the guitars are actually in tune. Not perfectly in tune, but they are more in tune, and everything is in time. In fact, this song actually has a really nice groove. the second to last track is called What Should I Do? The song is all about how one of the girls is dating a really not nice person, and she really wants to break up with them, but she really doesn't know how to do it. Man, the Shags walked so Taylor Swift could run. And finally, the last song is called We Have a Savior. This one's bad because it's just not very interesting in my opinion. This album, I think the best word to describe it is fascinating. It really is an awful album, but again, what I did was I ignored the awful qualities about it, and I decided to start taking the music in for what it is. And I found that the songs are actually very good. Now, don't go thinking you're gonna be getting a break from bad music quite just yet. Nope, nuh-uh. Cause next time, we're reviewing Captain Beefheart and his magic band's Trout Mask Replica, the most infamous album ever. Well, that's about it. I've said all I want about the Shags, and really, this album, it is bad, but it's also great. Keep on going, Shags. Or should I say, keep on shagging.